Reverend Father Neil Hewitt, Dr. Bill Saltman, Executive Director of the Catholic Education Services, Honourable Mayor and Mayoress, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of this community. What a beautiful place. I spent some time before this week knowing that this would be the first, in many ways the most important opportunity I'd have to express the ambassadorship for this Catholic Education Week, preparing some remarks. And they led upon a sense of community, especially the sort of sense of community I saw in such abundance after Cyclone Larry and the rehabilitation efforts. What I see day by day as Chancellor of the Australian Catholic University, perhaps my major credential for being your ambassador. Speaking about my own school. All of that I've put to one side. All of that because of the experience of being with you for this Mass today, in this beautiful place. The theme of your Education Week is celebrating community, family, parish, school. Today's Mass embodies that in all of its manifestations. Many of you, especially the more mature age ones of you, will recall that I had the enormous privilege to lead a multinational force at what might be called, in international diplomatic terms, the moment of deliverance for the people of East Timor. And at the end of that mission, I was frequently asked, because people were wanting to understand how that whole thing unfolded. What was that moment? Was there a moment when I knew that our mission would succeed? And I think when those questions came my way, people would have been surprised. When I didn't name some arcane moment of a military schedule of aeroplanes and ships and soldiers on the ground, nor some diplomatic moment with the signature upon a piece of paper, nor indeed a media report or a proceeding in the Security Council of the United Nations. But instead a moment just like this, in Dili Cathedral. Now, many of you will recall that the population of Dili largely fled while rampaging mobs killed them, maimed them, burnt their homes. And then after the force arrived and those people felt safe to return to their homes, Bishop Bellow, the Nobel Laureate, called for a solemn Mass in the Dili Cathedral to celebrate what they felt was their deliverance. Now their cathedral is a solemn place, not as beautiful as this wonderful cathedral here, but theirs and their place of refuge and worship, a bigger place than this. It was crammed to overflowing. All of the aisles were full. Hundreds and hundreds gathered in the grounds of the cathedral outside. I said to my own staff that I would attend this moment, not just as a Catholic, but to show solidarity with the people of East Timor. We snuck into the back, in the back pew. Somebody told Bishop Bellow in the vestry that he had a couple of military visitors, and he came charging down the aisle, partly robed, and grabbed me by the hand and led me to the front row. I was embarrassed. Fortunately, he didn't have to throw out any East Timorese to make room, but I had a front row seat. this wonderful service they pursued, all in terror, which I do not speak. I understood from time to time that the wonderful men and women of my force were getting a reference because there is no terror word for interfet, and it occasionally cropped up in his sermon and in his prayers. But what was obvious to me was the sense of community, family groups, that great, enormous parish, which is the East Timorese, and those who are gathered together in this church, and like your choir today, but multiplied 10 times over by the full throatedness and the devotional singing of every member of the congregation, they lifted their voices to the heavens in their hymns of thanksgiving for this moment of deliverance. That's when I knew that the East Timor mission was a success. That's when I knew that the spirit of this community, of those families, of the parish, of the kids who were thirsting for education at school, that spirit was indomitable, could never be oppressed. Not by 25 years of an unwelcome administration, not by any man-made event, nor anything nature can throw at them. So to me, to come here today and to experience this wonderful Mass, attended not just by the parishioners of this parish, but by youngsters in school uniform, whom I believe later I'll have a chance to speak with. To me, you have provided for this first and therefore most challenging of my ambassadorial roles, you have provided for the rest of my time the wind beneath my wings. God bless you.